Yes, ma'am.
Archana ma'am, may I start on a lighter note, please, with your permission?
Sure, dear.
I was told the speech has to be for 1 minute. Then later on, we got the message that the speech is for 2 minutes. So, ma'am, 3 minutes I've prepared, and I'll request you if you can prolong to 1 more minute, because I really have a lot to say about this project, and I've been waiting, jotting down points, ma'am. See, I have a diary and I have jotted down points to speak, because this project, the way I connected, and moreover, ma'am, leave it to me, when I was working with kids, the connection, the change that I saw, I really feel I really need to put it across. So, ma'am, now with this note, I'll start, ma'am. I'll start the quote, ma'am, written by Fred Kaufman, who said that wisdom without compassion is ruthlessness, and compassion without wisdom is folly. And the live example of this, ma'am, was recently we all came to know about Amazon. The boss himself, Jeff Bezos, he is making big time money. We all have been shopping and doing everything on Amazon, but his employees are not happy because they say that we've been treating like machines. So he doesn't have compassion. And if over a period of time it continues in the same way, we are all going to witness a downfall in that company. So that is the one thing that you all brought up. The project, Shaurya Project, ma'am, the Connect Plus gave us the platform. We all knew about words. I won't be wrong if I say that we all knew about sympathy. We all knew about empathy. But we all lacked compassion. Because empathy, we could feel if someone was in pain, we saw and we just walked by. Compassion came in us when we thought, no, let me go and help that person. Okay, if he or she is sitting all alone, let me just take an extra mile and talk to that person that what is the problem. And I saw this thing when, ma'am, we were made a part of a particular project group, and we were told that we are going to help out the students in assembling and organizing and doing the things. I thought, okay, let me do my bit. But I was taken aback when the students, they were coming forward and they were saying, ma'am, it's okay. If he can't do it, I'll do his share of work and then we'll all assemble it. It's okay, ma'am. He has his tuitions or she has some work. We'll all do it. Then I knew that we are all a success. This project that we started, it sorted out. We are all sorted. This is what we wanted. Compassion. This is what we wanted. Empathy. And it's there in them. They all have their exams. Nobody is worried. Nobody is thinking that, you know, he might score more or she might score more. They are still working for each other. So that was one point where I got it, that we have achieved, at least we've come halfway maybe, that what we wanted to. Then, ma'am, moving on next, I realized that this compassion and empathy is contagious. If I was smiling and having a positive thing towards someone, I don't think so anybody would come and just suddenly shout at me. Yes, again, on a lighter side, if a person is some in reality show, you never know. He might just come fight back. But in real world, nobody does that, ma'am. So it is contagious. Your teammates, your peers, your parents, your child. If you don't shout, nobody shouts. So why unnecessarily create a turbulence in the whole world when everything can be done in a very positive way? So I would like to say it is a positive chain back. Archana, ma'am, I would like to add on over here. When we started the first session, and I still remember I questioned you, ma'am, that means if we say sorry or if we are submissive or we don't answer back, so is it okay? Don't you think so that people would say that she doesn't speak up, she doesn't point up things? And the answer that you replied to me, that Bhanu, it's not like that. It is something that you need to work on. Once you understand the mind of the other person will relate to you. Your answer was one thing, ma'am, that made me follow this project and the webinar. And over the period of sessions, I realized one thing, ma'am, that no, complying to someone, saying yes or sorry to someone is not meaning slaves. I understood empathy and compassion means to hold the reins of yourself. Don't be an autopilot. Don't let people come and let the biases come in you and you judge the people. Always be defensive if you don't like someone. I understood I have to be on manual settings where I don't have to let the personal judgment come in between. I realized that no, you know, if he or she is reacting this way today, maybe he or she is having a bad day. So why always be that always under the pressure? No, she'll speak, she'll always speak against me. So I understood that thing. So thank you, Archana ma'am and Shaurya team. I am really, really blessed. I know my all these students, they have grown. And I just hope that we all keep growing. On this, I would like to end with a very short note, ma'am, said by Plato, that be kind. Be kind to whomsoever you meet. Because you never know whom the person interacting with you having a harder battle. So he might be fighting something harder. So just be kind to everyone. So thank you, ma'am, for taking us to a journey.